been 60 hours now since life stood still for a moment at the mall in Columbia. Tonight, residents are trying to get back some sense of normalcy.
Trying, and this comes as the community is left with reminders of what happened when a 19-year-old walked in with a shotgun, killed two people, and then killed himself. To honor the victims, 25-year-old Tyler Johnson and 21-year-old Brianna Benlolo, there are now two memorial sites at the mall, one outside, another inside at the mall's fountain. And then there's the closed-off entrance and tribute at the store where the shooting took place.
But Kate, the big unanswered question tonight, why did Darian Aguilar do it? We have team coverage, beginning with 11 News reporter George Lettuce, who joins us live at the mall tonight. And George, are we any closer to knowing the answer to that question?
Well, detectives say they continue to get what they describe as helpful information that may get them closer to answering that question, but right now nothing definitive to release about a motive. A journal may help, but more on that in a moment. As you said, the mall reopened today, but today was not business as usual. 2 days after the deadly shooting at a skate store at the mall at Columbia, the store, Zumiez, was boarded up, but the mall was back open, but it was not back to normal. Flags were at half staff outside, and inside the mall, shoppers who did not let Saturday's violence deter them tell us there was a different mood in the air.
Very quiet, subdued, a bit somber, more quiet than normally a Monday is. Seemed to be on everyone's minds.
And there was still a heavy police presence.
Not only just the regular security guards, but police as well as I believe some undercover. There were a lot of undercover people with hoodies, but they had walkie-talkies, you could kind of tell.
Two memorial sites are at the mall now, honor the victims, 25-year-old Tyler Johnson and 21-year-old Brianna Benlolo. Police say for reasons still unknown, 19-year-old Darian Aguilar shot and killed the Zumiez skate shop employees with a shotgun, and then police say killed himself.
Senseless.
A man who says he was in the store during the shooting says he saw Aguilar come out of a dressing room and walk toward the female victim, Benlolo.
Didn't see the shotgun that second, but I saw him raise it up, take a few steps towards the girl Brianna, take aim, and shoot her in her upper body or her head.
The man says he got down on the floor behind the counter. 10 seconds later, he heard the shot that police say killed Johnson. The man says he crawled out of the store and ran away yelling, "Shooter."
He was just silent, focused, no sort of expression or emotion.
During a symbolic lunch at the mall food court, Howard County Executive Ken Ullman says investigators continue to work on unraveling the mystery behind the motive.
This is a murder investigation. It happened to take place in a very public place, but we're doing our best to better understand why this happened.
And detectives say they've recovered the shooter's journal. In it, he expresses some kind of dissatisfaction with life. Meantime, officials say that heightened security here at the mall will last through the week. We're live in Columbia. George Lettuce, WBAL-TV 11 News.